This message is for you, the 2022 Annual Catholic Appeal donors. Decorating their Christmas tree, the children of St. Stanislaus Kostka School in Adams know each of these ornaments represents thousands of people who have been blessed by your generosity. Their lives are changed through the Annual Catholic Appeal ministries and social agencies.
Thank you, Annual Catholic Appeal donors.
All our lives, we've been told,
work hard,
achieve,
get to the next level.
But sometimes, our best efforts fall short. We start to think maybe we don't have what it takes.
Or maybe we do.
Jesus took on the sins of the whole world. He conquered even death itself.
He invites us to follow him. He wants us to trust him.
And through him, through his body and blood, we are united in Jesus.
And to each other.
Everything we're searching for.
Hail Mary, full of grace.
Our hopes and our dreams.
Who loves us unconditionally.
Who called us by name.
If you knew that receiving the Eucharist would change your life and change the world.
What will you do?
What would you do?
What would you do? Join us for the Year of the Eucharist.
Good morning and welcome to the Chalice of Salvation, coming to you from the Chapel of the Holy Spirit here in Springfield. I'm your Chalice host, Passionist Brother Terrence Scanlon, wishing you a very happy new year as together we usher in 2023. How appropriate that on the first day of every year we honor Mary, the Holy Mother of God, for it was her acceptance of God's plan that enabled the Incarnation and therefore initiated what in time became Christianity. Today is also the World Day of Peace, and so we look to Mary, the Queen of Peace, who bore the Prince of Peace, as our model and inspiration for holding peace in our hearts, our communities, and in our world. Our Mass presider today will be Father Dewey Lay, parochial vicar at St. Mary Parish in Westfield. Father has been joined by students and faculty of St. Mary's High School. They will be our readers, altar servers, and music ministers for today's liturgy. Our Mass intention this day is offered in loving memory of Sandra M. Lombardo on the first anniversary of her passing. This Mass has been requested by her mother and former co-worker here at the diocese, Eunice Pellegrini. And we offer our heartfelt good wishes to all who are celebrating their special birthdays or anniversaries throughout the coming week. Special birthday greetings to Ann Conroy, a loyal Chalice viewer from Chicopee, who is celebrating her 92nd birthday tomorrow. Annie is the proud mother of 10 children, 35 grand, and great-grandchildren. Happy birthday to you, Annie. We also remember and pray for all those who are ill or homebound, keeping in mind those of you in our viewing community who watch this telecast from your hospital rooms and nursing homes. Please know that we are thinking of you and those special people who care for your needs. And of course, as we do each week, we enroll the names that you have sent in to us for today's Book of Remembrance. May these and all the souls of the faithfully departed rest in the loving embrace of God. And following our liturgy today, Steve Katanik will introduce us to Pauline Lamothe, who at 100 years old is still going strong with her lifetime love of music. It's right after our Mass, so please stay tuned. Let us now join with our music director, Rob LePage, and the students from St. Mary's High School, and welcome Father Lay for the celebration of the Solemnity of Mary, the Holy Mother of God.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, everyone. You know, hopefully not too much of a hangover. You know, let us come together as we celebrate this divine mystery on the Solemnity of Mary, the Holy Mother of our God. And so let us prepare ourselves, recall our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who through the fruitful virginity of Blessed Mary bestow on the human race the grace of eternal salvation, grant, we pray, that we may experience the intercession of her through whom we were found worthy to receive the author of life, our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them, this is how you should bless the Israelites. Say to them, The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. So shall they invoke my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Nations on the earth you guide. May God bless us in his mercy. May the peoples praise you, O God. May all the peoples praise you. May God bless us. And may all the ends of the earth fear him. May God bless us in his mercy.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to ransom those under the law, so that we might receive adoption as sons. As proof that you are sons, God sent the spirit of his son into our hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then also an heir, through God, the word of the Lord.
Spoke to our ancestors through the prophets. In these last days, he has spoken to us through the Son. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The shepherds went in haste to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told by them. By what had been told them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. When 8 days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord. As we join together for the celebration of Mary, Mother of God, right, and especially for the New Year, right, New Year is always a time for us to reflect, right, and especially reflect on the difficulties that we have been through. At the same time, all those New Year resolutions that we try and fail, but we try it every year, right? That's the whole point of being a Christian, to keep trying. Right? Christ is not saying you get one chance. And that's it. Right? That's why the sacraments are repeatable, most of them. Right? And so as we reflect upon our struggles through the past year, and as we look forward to the new year, right, the new coming, right, we look at time that we can give thanks, right? Because we can always find moments, even at our weakness, that we can give thanks whether to others or to God. Right? Mostly we want to give thanks to God because we realize that ultimately he's the one that continue to walk with us. Right? But New Year's also a time, especially as we celebrated Christmas. Right? Holidays is a time for some, if not most of us, right? It's tiresome. Right? With all the preparations, what we have to buy, what we have to prepare, all the parties, all the preparations and whatnot, right? And sometimes if we are feeling down, we cannot even feel sad, right? Because people are going to say, you're a Grinch, right? Why are you ruining holidays for everyone else, right? So it's hard. It's a hard time to celebrate our holiday seasons, right? But today we celebrate this feast, right? The feast of Mary, Mother of God, right? The octave of Christmas, when right, the shepherds and all went in haste to Bethlehem because they heard of this, right? Jesus, right? God visiting, right? With all this light, the stars guiding and whatnot. So they were marvel at what they have seen, right? For a lot of us, when we look at a manger, right? Nowadays, we look at a manger and some of them, we said, oh, that's so cute, with all the animal, with the baby in the middle, with, Joseph, Mary, but it's cold, right? If we put ourselves in Mary or Joseph or even an animal situations, right? Outside, in the wind, right? The mangers have all sort of openings, right? Having a baby in the mangers, right? With a mom that could not find an inn. It's not, for us, it's kind of cute now. I wouldn't say so for Joseph, at least, right? As the man of the house, trying to provide for his pregnant wife, and after Jesus is born, trying to keep him as warm as they can. Right? Today's feast invites us to share in this awe that Mary had, right? Mary marveled at all the shepherds have said, right? And then we have the three kings coming. Right? Mary marveled at all the support that she's receiving from God, right? She said yes to God, not fully know what to expect, right? She doesn't even know how she's going to give birth when she's a virgin herself. Right? The title Mother of God is one of Mary's most exalted titles. And yet, this feast delivers a humble and simple scene. Right? Mary accepting God's plan. Right? At the same time, be at awe at his plan. As we reflect on Mary, we have to think about Jesus, right? Because Mary's always lead us to Jesus. Right? That's her role. Her role is to bring us to her son. Right? Hope is something that many of us can have, right? Hope is something in which people before Jesus had, right? They had hope of a Messiah. They had hope of a Savior, right? If you're in war, if you are hungry, you hope for not being hungry and whatnot. When Jesus arrived, right, he gave hope a completely new meaning. Right? No one would have hoped for an eternal life. No one would have hoped for a life with and in God. Right? We hope for a better day. We hope for a better year. We hope for, you know, that everything's go well. We hope for peace and whatnot. But when Jesus arrived, right, we can hope for heaven. Right? Because Jesus opened the gates of heaven. And it is through Mary that this hope can be nourished. It is said of Mary that she treasured all these things as the shepherds said to her, and as she pondered them in her heart. And it reminds us to treasure all that we have heard, right? Throughout the past couple of weeks, right? All we have heard about this Savior who had come and who is coming again, right? The pondering of this wonderful richness, right? And on this first day of the new year, we commit ourselves as we set up new year resolutions. How are we pondering, right, the next years with God's grace? Right? Or do we just want to make resolutions and put God aside? Right? As Jesus told his disciples whom he loved, right, on Calvary, it was not named that disciples. Right? Put ourselves be that disciples. When he said, right, behold your mother. Right, put ourselves at Calvary as we're going to celebrate, you know, Lent, you know, in 2 months. Right? As we celebrate, as we continue our year, right, we reflect upon this message of Mary as our mother. Right? She will bring us to Jesus. Right? That's her role. And that's what she's willing to do. That's why we have so many Marian apparitions, right? Marian appearances. That's why every Mary appearances have the baby Jesus, or if you have Our Lady of Guadalupe, right, you have that little maternity belt. Right? Mary, as we pray the rosary, we are not praying for Mary. We pray that Mary, who is also our mother, bring us to her son.
So let us join together as we proclaimed our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As sons and daughters of God, we cry out, Abba, Father, with our needs and the needs of our sisters and brothers.
Our response will be, Lord, hear us. For the church, that we may imitate the shepherds in proclaiming the good news of the Son of God, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear us. That we may overcome the fear of cynicism that hold us back from working for peace among nations and peace among people, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear us. For all those who have fled their homes because of war, violence, or persecution, that they may find peace and refuge in their new homes, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear us. For all mothers, like our Blessed Mother, they have joyful memories to treasure in their hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
That we may glorify and praise God through our words and actions, sharing in the joy and amazement of the shepherds when they first learned the message of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
We remember Sandra M. Lombardo, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for the names we will enter into our Book of Remembrance this day. Let us pray to the Lord.
God of peace and justice, we your children cry out to you, longing for peace, desperate for justice. Hear our cries and the prayers we offer through the intercession of our Holy Mother, Blessed Virgin Mary. Amen. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. O God, who in your kindness begin all good things and bring them to fulfillment, grant to us who find joy in the solemnity of the Holy Mother of God, that just as we glory in the beginning of your grace, so one day we may rejoice in its completion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's end, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you look on the lowliness of your handmaid, you give us through her the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, bestowing down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and William our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph her spouse, with the blessed apostles and other saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Save us, command, and form by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. We have received this heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that it may lead us to eternal life, for we rejoice to proclaim the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son and Mother of the Church, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Let us join together as we pray for all holy vocations. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hours of our death. Amen. Now, before we end, I would like to thank, you know, our Chalice of Salvation staff for having us here. You know, thank you, Mr. LePage, for playing the piano, Caleb for serving, you know, Lynn and Kathleen for readings, and our St. Mary's High School Choir for your beautiful voices. The Lord be with you. May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Our family is made up of every race. We are young and old, rich and poor, men and women, sinners and saints. Our family has spanned the centuries and the globe. With God's grace, we started hospitals to care for the sick. We establish orphanages and help the poor. We are the largest charitable organization on the planet, bringing relief and comfort to those in need. We educate more children than any other scholarly or religious institution. We developed the scientific method and laws of evidence. We founded the college system. We defend the dignity of all human life and uphold marriage and family. Cities were named after our revered saints who navigated a sacred path before us. Guided by the Holy Spirit, we compiled the Bible. We are transformed by sacred scripture and sacred tradition, which have consistently guided us for 2,000 years. We are the Catholic Church. With over 1 billion in our family, sharing in the sacraments and fullness of the Christian faith, for centuries we have prayed for you and our world, every hour of every day, whenever we celebrate the Mass. Jesus himself laid the foundation for our faith when he said to Peter, the first pope,
You are rock, and upon this rock I will build my church. For over 2,000 years, we've had an unbroken line of shepherds, guiding the Catholic Church with love and truth in a confused and hurting world. And in this world filled with chaos, hardship, and pain, it's comforting to know that some things remain consistent, true, and strong, our Catholic faith, and the eternal love that God has for all creation. If you've been away from the Catholic Church, we invite you to take another look. Visit CatholicsComeHome.org today. Ours is one family, united in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. We are Catholic. Welcome home.
This message is for you, the 2022 Annual Catholic Appeal donors. Decorating their Christmas tree, the children of St. Stanislaus Kostka School in Adams know each of these ornaments represents thousands of people who have been blessed by your generosity. Their lives are changed through the Annual Catholic Appeal ministries and social agencies.
Thank you, Annual Catholic Appeal donors.
Today is New Year's Day, and Happy New Year's. And we celebrate this in a most special way by commemorating our Blessed Mother as the Mother of God, that she was the one who bore Christ into the world. Mary is our dignity and our destiny, and she asks us to do just the same, to bring Jesus into the world anew. We receive him in the Eucharist. We carry him in our body as she did, and so too, through our love, through our faith, through our hope, bring Jesus into a world that needs him desperately. So make that your New Year's resolution, to bring Jesus into our world. Happy New Year and Merry Christmas.
Walt Disney once said, "Laughter is timeless, imagination has no age, and dreams are forever." A Springfield parishioner has put those words into practice, showing everyone around her that age shouldn't be a barrier to achieving anything in life. Steve Katonic has a story of Pauline Prince Lamont.
It's the 8:30 a.m. Mass at St. Mary's in Westfield. Sitting in her usual seat up in the choir loft is Pauline Prince Lamoth. A chairlift is available, but Pauline chooses to walk up the narrow staircase, which is quite an achievement when one considers her age. Pauline was born when President Warren G. Harding was in the White House. The year was 1922, which puts her age at 100. Pauline has sung in St. Mary's Choir with her daughter Judy and son-in-law every week since 2008. And before that, in the closed St. Joseph's Choir for 35 years. Rob LePage is the music director.
Everything Pauline does, she brings joy and good humor. She brings a sense of commitment. She brings a sense of faith and family that we can all learn from. She's made it to 100 years for a reason, but her love of music and the music that she's loved her whole life, she's able to bring that and inspire others with that.
This centenarian has remained active her whole life. Pauline still drives her car to attend a prayer group and daily mass at her home parish, Mary Mother of Hope in Springfield. And she has played violin in the old Post Road Orchestra for over 20 years. Pauline is following in her father's footsteps, who she said lived to be 106.
I'm like my father, I think. If you can walk, you can do anything. That's my father used to say. You can walk, you can go there.
Pauline was one of 17 children, 9 boys and 8 girls, born to Albert and Delima Lamoth in a small town in Quebec, Canada. When Pauline was small, the family moved to Nashua, New Hampshire, where her father opened a jewelry shop.
But in 1929, when the crash came in, my father lost his shirt, lost the money we had in the bank, and the jewelry shop had to close, and the bank had everything. So then they had to start from scratch. So my father went to the shoe shop.
Growing up in a large family wasn't always easy.
We had to get along. The oldest people, the oldest ones work hard because we had to take care of the young one, you see?
Faith was important to Pauline and her siblings who attended Catholic schools.
We said the rosary every night at 6 o'clock. Anybody that came in our house at 6 o'clock, in the house, the door was closed.
During World War II, while 7 of her brothers served, Pauline worked at Chapton Valve doing peace work. When it closed, she went to Monsanto, where she met her husband, Joseph Lamoth, whom she married in 1947. They had 7 children, all of whom are successful. Singing was always a big part of Pauline's life.
I was 5 years old, I sang solo, C'est le grand jour of my first communion.
While French was the primary language spoken in the household, Pauline recalls the first English song and words she learned at age 1.
My mother had me in a box on the porch, and the woman next door, her husband had stolen a bread, a 5-cent bread, so he was 6 months in jail. So all she sang on the rocking chair was, I wish I had someone to love me, someone I could call my own. And so I learned it by heart.
Pauline sang in the St. Aloysius High School choir and led the band during town parades. At 18, while visiting her aunt in Springfield, Pauline attended a 4th of July party at Belleye's nightclub.
Kate Smith was supposed to come and sing. And there were a storm that stopped them from coming in on time. So this man stands up and he said, anybody in the audience can sing? And my aunt went like this to me. So, and I had just won a contest on singing God Bless America, imitating Kate Smith.
God bless America, land that I love.
And people that were late coming in, they said, oh, Kate Smith is really here. And that, you know who the orchestra was? Jimmy Dorsey.
Years later, Pauline came out of the crowd again to sing with another famous performer.
America the Beautiful, I sang there.
With Cesar Romero.
With Cesar Romero.
At Riverside Park?
At Riverside Park.
Pauline has played violin since she was 5. All her siblings played an instrument selected by her mother.
She gave it to me because nobody wanted it. And I used to get laughed at. They called me Zing Zing.
Pauline credits Sister Raphael for letting her practice violin in the convent. But while walking home from school one day, it was an unknown woman who boosted her confidence.
She said, you know, you stick to it, because my grandfather was a very good violin player, but when he was your age, he couldn't play a string. And it stayed here, see?
So that kept you going?
It kept me going.
The violin has been a lifelong passion of Pauline's. At 13, her talent led her to play solo with the Lowell Symphony Orchestra. Pauline practices 20 minutes each day and has been the second violin in the old Post Road Orchestra for over 20 years. Here performing in their recent Rockin' Holiday show at Mary Mother of Hope Church. Elaine Gernix has been playing with Pauline for years.
Pauline is amazing. Pauline is generous. Pauline is selfless. She cares for others. She looks out for the welfare of others. She's a real community member of this orchestra.
Pauline, who has lived in the same house for 68 years, retired as an elderly caregiver in 2016 at 94. 6 siblings are still alive, although she recently lost her 97-year-old sister, Joanne. As for any words of wisdom,
giving is better than receiving. Because you know the face of the first, especially when they need it. Try to be charitable with them. Don't ever put anybody down.
And the keys to her longevity?
Faith, love, and work. I had the best husband you ever saw in your life. I have a lot of faith. Everything I do, thank God. Whether it's bad or good.
With her humor, positive outlook, strong character, and zest for life, Pauline Prince-Lamothe remains an inspiration to anyone who meets her. In Springfield, I'm Steve Kiltonic.
Thanks, Steve, for that touching story. Pauline, you are an inspiration to all of us. We extend our thanks to Father Dewey Lay for celebrating our Chalice Mass this day, and to members of St. Mary's High School in Westfield who joined us. Before we leave you this day, we want to thank all who have so generously responded to our Christmas appeal. We are most grateful to all. Asking you to join us again next Sunday as we continue our Christmas season and celebrate the Feast of the Epiphany as we welcome Father Mark Stelzer and members of the Elms College as our special guests and highlight the College of Our Lady of the Elms in Chicopee. That's next Sunday at the same time, right here in the Chalice of Salvation, your weekly spiritual connection. Sending all in our viewing community our love and prayers. God bless, See you next Sunday.
All our lives, we've been told.
Work hard.
Achieve.
Get to the next level.
But sometimes, our best efforts fall short. We start to think maybe we don't have what it takes.
Or maybe we do.
Jesus took on the sins of the whole world. He conquered even death itself.
He invites us to follow him. He wants us to trust him.
And through him, through his body and blood, we are united in Jesus.
And to each other.
Everything we're searching for.
Hail Mary, full of grace.
Our hopes and our dreams.
Points to the Father.
Who loves us unconditionally.
Who called us by name.
If you knew that receiving the Eucharist would change your life,
what will you do?
What would you do?
What would you do? Join us for the Year of the Eucharist.